We are all pained to see that this Vedic period is being called by the Westerners as Iron Age. Iron Age! It is Vedic Age. Vedas, Puranas and Itihas give us ample indication of ancient Indian civilization. Over a period of time, we have lost it, and there is a misconception that these Vedas preaches only a spiritual pathway for the human beings to attain moksha, which is totally wrong. Only the last portion of the Vedas gives this spiritual information. And how old are these Vedas? They are anadi. Hindu scriptures actually record in terms of four yugas. There is a Kali, we are in Kali Yuga today, and Dwapara Yuga, where Lord Krishna lived, and then Treta Yuga and Krita Yuga. So the time is running to lakhs and crores of years before, and Vedic knowledge, Vedas were practiced even in Krita Yuga. That means it is anadi. So there is a misconception. And what do we get from these Vedas? Everything. You have everything, right from weaponry to metallurgy to astrology to astronomy to everything, to for yoga, meditation, spiritual, and even weaponry for that matter. Everything, farming, everything. Only what existed for so many years got destroyed in few years of time. The knowledge of a farmer can attain the knowledge about farming, even Shilpa Shastra, which is agamas, construction, the architecture, everything was in Vedas. But somehow there is a wrong propaganda which has destroyed the Vedic wisdom, and it is time that we have to bring it back. You have four Vedas: Rig Veda, Yajur Veda, Sama Veda and Atharvan Veda. All these four Vedas teach us everything, everything for materialistic as well as spiritual life, for peaceful living. Coming back to Vedas, the primary knowledge, Vedas always says individuals have to strive for pure knowledge. When you call it pure knowledge, wisdom, which is devoid of any kind of error, which should be preached by the seers and saints, and which has been practiced over lakhs and lakhs of years. So what do they say? They say in order an individual has to obtain true knowledge, there are only three things which has been even approved by Vasishtadvaita. One is pramanam, means pure knowledge, and pramanam, how to attain pramanam, is by prameyam, the tools which is being used to get pure knowledge, and pramadhata, that is the subject, the individual who uses these instruments, tools, to attain pure knowledge. So Veda says in order to attain pure knowledge, and pramanam is the pure knowledge, and how do we get? We get by three means. What is that? One is pratyaksha, the second one is anumana, third one is shabda. Pratyaksha is what you see. It is called, as in English you call it as a perception. You can perceive a thing using your sensory organs like nanendriyam and karmendriyam. Try to recollect. Suppose if you perceive a book to be a book, if someone has told you that it is a book, you could able to relate it to the book by using your mind and manas. Suppose in case if you use your nanendriya and karmendriya wrongly, you may have the organs, because science says by our organs we are trying to establish, we are trying to find out an object and try to name the object. This is my wife. This is my son, this is object. No, you may have sensory organs, but still if you do not have the nanendriya like mind and manas, you cannot relate what you see and perceive the things correctly. So perception is called as pratiksha in Sanskrit, pratiksham. So one is pratiksha, second one is hanumana. Suppose if there is a smoke, you think that there is could be a fire. This is called inference. This inference cannot happen without pratiksha. Pratiksha means you have to see. So they are interrelated. So anumana can be by pratiksha also. The last one is shabda. Shabda is verbal, which is sound. The perception is of three kinds. Knowing the subject, that is me, that I am the subject. Object in front of me. And consciousness, that this subject, this object, what I see is this. So three things are important. These three things are accepted by even Vasishtadvaita when we try to understand who is a god. Hanumana is where, while pratiksha refers to direct perception. Anumana refers to inference cognition. That means you arrive at a conclusion based on the evidence of some related items. As an example, you observe smoke and you think fire could be there. The last one is Shabda, which is called as the sound. A statement by an authoritative, when it is uttered by a trustworthy person, free of errors, and discussed at a later stage, that's called as Veda. Who is the founder? Anadi. And Veda, God says, it is my breath. My breath is Veda. So no individual has written Vedas. Vedas are very old, and Vedas, Smritis, Itihas, and Puranas come much later. In order to understand Vedas, Vedas were only one big one, Vedvyas, and he divided the Vedas into four Vedas. He only compiled it in four Vedas, brought it under four categories, four Vedas. Otherwise, the Veda was only a single one, a source of great information about everything, whether it's spiritual or materialistic world. So it is right time that we understand Vedas from this perception, that it is not just a spiritual information, but 90% of it is weaponry, metallurgy, Ayurveda, and astronomy, the yagamas, the architecture, everything inbuilt is Vedas. And if you want to know it, we need to really should have known Sanskrit. And the Dravida Veda is of Tamil, but Sanskrit is very important to understand these Vedas. Over a period of time, this completely got destroyed by a new education system, which has just happened about 150-200 years back.